All right, known as the king of Venice Beach, comedian Michael Collier is known for his point-blank delivery that definitely brings the funny each and every time.
Oh, he already has us laughing this weekend. He's headlining at Chuckles. But right here in Memphis, but he stopped by live at 9.
So beautiful.
You're looking sharp, and you brought a friend with you.
Yeah, that's the chicken. Everybody likes chicken. Well, you know, black people love chicken. Well, I can't speak for all black people. I'm not Kanye. But all the black people I know that aren't vegetarians, they love chicken.
Not vegetarians.
Yeah. If you're not vegetarian, you love chicken.
If you're not, we got you covered.
This chicken don't have nothing to do with anything.
That's it.
I don't even know why it's here this morning. Good morning. How y'all doing?
We're doing great. What's on your mind these days? We noticed you came in with the fist bump.
Gotta do the bump.
A few concerns there about
coronavirus. It ain't no joke. You know, I found it. There's three things you have to do. First of all, you want to stay away from people who are sneezing or coughing.
Okay.
If people are sneezing or coughing, if you're within 6 feet of that virus, mm-hmm. you can get it. Second, you want to wash your hands for real.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
That means don't get that little sanitizer and do it.
You want to get hot water with soap and wash your fingertips. You sound like a health expert over there almost.
And then the third thing, you know, no black people have contact. So the third thing is stay away from white folks.
Oh, boy.
You want to stay alive, you better bump and walk.
We did the elbow bump, we did the fist bump.
You got to do all of that. You know, it is serious, though, so you want to be careful with that, man. Your health is everything, man.
Yes.
You want to be alive so you can come see my show this weekend.
We got to be back because you got a lot of shows this weekend.
Oh, we got a lot of shows, man.
We have seen you in movies, TV, and, of course, you're also an author. What haven't you done
Well, you know,
yet?
That's interesting you said that, too, because I have my newest book. It's called Michael Goes Motivational.
Okay.
It's motivational speaking from a comedic point of view. So I figure if you could get people to laugh, they let their guards down. When they let their guards down, you slip information in. You know, one of the things I teach is that if you want to do anything in this world, you can do it if you spend 15 minutes a day towards it. 5 days a week.
Right.
You could take Saturday and Sunday off.
And you have been doing this for so long. That's what I was just about to say. Been in the game a long time.
Yeah.
How do you continue? You know, what continues to inspire you and just continue pushing along to do what you do?
Well, good old God, G-O-D. You know, everything's about family and God. Once you get family and God down, everything else takes care of itself. Mm-hmm. So I'm excited about life. You know, I'm in love with a queen who likes me and loves me.
Yeah.
You know, and I wake up to her every morning. And I'm just, first thing I do is I get up and I pray. Well, I brush my teeth first because I don't like to talk to God with a dirty mouth. But then I say my prayers, you know. But my prayers are always prayers of gratitude.
Yeah.
It's never begging, oh, God, give me that. Because God wants you to have what you want to have.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you'd be clear mm-hmm. in your intentions. Some people say, the universe cursed me. Some people say, the universe blessed me. It don't do either one. The universe responds to your vibration.
Response.
Whatever you're sending out is what the universe
is. So that energy
back.
Is right. important.
Yeah, I wake up in the morning on fire. Man, I can't wait to go. What can I discover today?
One thing that's so cool about you, every time that you've come through, you're always very open, you're very honest, and you share some of the struggles you've gone through life.
Hopefully, it
especially
helps other people.
These days, you're looking great. Sobriety. We know what that means to you.
It's big for me. In fact, this past Sunday was March 1st. It's my 9th year of pure sobriety after 23 years of smoking crack. And I figured that I could stand as an example to other people. Because if I can get off after 23 years, what if you're only on for 2 years or 4 years and think, oh, I'm stuck, I can't get off? You can turn and look at me and see that if you really put your heart in it, if you really keep God and family first, you can break that cycle.
You had me wondering, though. You were still at that time point, I can only assume, still doing so much.
Everything.
You still seem
working.
Like you were productive.
I was
did
a functional
friends,
addict.
Did they know?
No, nobody knew I was getting high except folks getting high with me and the people selling it to me. Nobody else really knew, you know. I was a functional addict, but I was functional while being dysfunctional, you know, because I was able to work. I mean, I was doing film, TV, I was still writing books, doing motivational speaking, doing comedy, but I go on the side behind doors when people ain't watching and do my thing, you know. But along the way, I lost so many friends and relationships and opportunities, you know, and I just got sick and tired of being sick and tired of my wife crying when I'm coming home 3:30 in the morning, tiptoeing in, trying not to wake her up, heart pumping fast, sweating like R. Kelly in a playground. So
in a playground.
So, you know, all of that sort of, I changed that, and the gifts of sobriety is everything.
We got
you. I mean, now I got my own. I never owned property, and now I own property. Now I'm on 5 projects. I have my new book, Michael Goes Motivated. Foundation on.
And it chuckles.
That's it.
And that chuckles. Five big shows, y'all.
There's the information right there. Michael Collier, thank you very much.
God bless you.
For always being here.
Thank you very much.
All right.
Appreciate it.
Appreciate it.